Hey everyone. So over the weekend, I got the opportunity to play around with a Surface Book. Not the second generation, but the first. And while this is not an unboxing video, it's also not a review. Well, it kind of is, and it's not. It's a bit complicated. Stay tuned. After much thought about it and after the Samsung Galaxy Book, I really wanted to try my hand at another Windows machine. So I took the plunge and I ordered a Surface Book 1. It was what I could afford since the Surface Book 2 is extremely expensive. But when it arrived via Amazon and I had the opportunity to open the box, I felt a slight flutter in my heart. This thing is beautiful. I've seen it countless times on the screen, but having it in front of me was something else. Despite my excitement to get into it and start using it, in the back of my mind, I did not allow myself to fall too deeply in love with it, because unfortunately, this was a refurbished unit, and those can go either which way, usually going the bad way. But nevertheless, I was excited. Installing Windows updates and my art programs like Adobe Photoshop and Clip Studio Paint didn't feel like a hassle this time around. Maybe because I was really excited about the hardware in front of me. Switching from laptop to tablet mode felt great and futuristic. I can't tell you how awesome it is to have a device that can easily switch between these two modes. The drawing experience was a mixed one. And to be fair, I've heard it gets better on the Surface Book 2. But in my experience on the Surface Book 1, it was a mixed experience. Photoshop was the biggest offender, again. The pen felt incredibly laggy in Photoshop, and I had to find a fix. See, the Surface Book has two GPUs, one on the tablet and the other on the keyboard. When attached to the keyboard, most programs like Photoshop will default to using its GPU, which is more powerful. To fix the lag in Photoshop, I had to force it to use the tablet's GPU instead. It was little things like this that made my time with the Surface Book a little uneasy. But in programs like Clip Studio Paint or the new art program Leonardo, the pen performed exceptionally well. This is when it got to shine for me. The screen felt like drawing on any tablet where you're basically drawing on glass. But thanks to the Surface Book's pen tip, there was a little tiny bit of resistance. Unfortunately, as happy as I was with the Surface Book experience, in the end, I had to return it. Everything went downhill my second night with it. After the battery went down below 10%, I plugged in the charger and noticed that it wasn't charging. I tried everything to get it to charge with no success. And the bad thing about the Surface Book is that if your battery goes below 10%, you can't detach the tablet from the keyboard base. Finally, after realizing that there was a problem with the keyboard battery, I decided it would be best to return it the next day. It was a hard thing to do. This device kind of won me over instantly. Now, is it better than an iPad Pro? No. And I realized that once I shipped it back and got an opportunity to draw on my iPad Pro again. The difference of drawing on the iPad Pro with the Apple Pencil compared to the Surface Book are night and day. Drawing on the iPad Pro after using the Surface Book for 2 straight days felt incredibly smooth and fluid and hassle-free. Everything just flowed as it should and everything just worked. And the biggest thing is that every single app I used did an amazing job of getting out of my way and letting me create. I was honestly amazed at the stark difference of drawing on the iPad Pro versus the Surface Book. And here's the thing about that. For a machine as expensive as the Surface Book is, you'd expect not only exceptional hardware, but also an amazing drawing experience. While the Surface Book is exceptionally well built and an incredibly beautiful machine, the drawing experience leaves much to be desired. And I cannot imagine that drawing on the Surface Book 2 will be leaps and bounds better than on the iPad Pro. To be clear, I hate the fact I had to return the Surface Book. I really, really hate it. It was everything I wanted in a mobile device minus the fantastic, unmatched drawing experience of an iPad Pro. And if I had to recommend it, I would without hesitation. But if I had to choose between it and the iPad Pro, as beautiful as the Surface Book is, I don't think I would sacrifice an amazing, unparalleled drawing experience for beautiful hardware. Hey guys, thanks for watching. Don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe for more videos. And I'll see you all in the next video. Until then, God bless you all. And peace.